Welcome to the video, Get to Know 7 Excellence Part 10. In this video, we will be discussing pH sensor calibration and verification. Let's get started with preparing the pH sensor for calibration. To ensure accurate results, sensor preparation steps need to be taken before calibration or verification. We will be using an in-lab Pro ISM sensor for this demonstration. First, you need to open the safety lock so that the electrolyte can flow into the sample. Then, carefully remove the wetting cap and place it aside. Next, place a waste beaker under the sensor and rinse the sensor with deionized water. Dabbing it dry with a tissue. Your sensor is now all set and ready for calibration. Now, let's move on to segmented calibration with 3 pH buffers. To do this, we'll use the 7 Excellence meter with the in-lab Pro ISM sensor placed in the U-place. For the segmented calibration, you will need 3 pH buffers 4.01, 7.00, and 9.21. During calibration, be sure to rinse the sensor with deionized water and dab it dry with a tissue in between buffers. To set the meter ready for the standard buffers, click on the pH module and select General Settings. Keep the endpoint type as automatic and the endpoint criteria as standard. Also, keep the temperature capture default, internal, as the sensor already contains the temperature probe. Once you're finished, click back. Next, select Measurement Settings, and keep pH for the measurement type, and the unit and decimal places set to 2. Then, select back. For calibration settings, keep the default European buffer group, select the calibration mode, segmented, and select the number of buffers used. Once you've made your selections, select back. Now, it's time to press calibrate to set the meter ready for the first standard. You will see a pop-up prompting you to immerse the sensor in the first standard. To start, prepare an aliquot of pH 4.01 in an empty and pre-labeled beaker. Pour about 40 milliliters into the beaker and close the bottle before setting it aside. Next, immerse the sensor into the beaker, making sure to fully submerge the sensor junction and membrane for accurate calibration results. Once that's done, click OK on the meter display to start the measurement. After the first point calibration is reached, you will see a pop-up prompting you to immerse the second buffer. Now, it's time to remove the pH buffer 4.01 beaker and rinse the sensor carefully with deionized water. Remember to carefully dab it dry with a tissue. Repeat this calibration process with the pH buffers 7.00 and 9.21. Once you reach the end point of pH buffer 9.21, you will see a pop-up showing the results of the calibration as slope and offset. It will also indicate whether the calibration results fulfill the acceptance criteria. Confirm the message by clicking OK. After the calibration, the next step is to perform verification with pH buffers 5.00 and 8.00 for each segment. In our case, we will be using pH buffers 5.00 and 8.00 since they're within the 3 calibration segments. To perform pH 5.00 verification, pour around 40 milliliters of the buffer into a pre-labeled beaker and immerse the sensor completely in the solution. Press read on the meter to start the verification. You'll see the reading on the meter, which you should wait for it to stabilize before removing the sensor from the beaker. Repeat the same verification procedure with the pH buffer 8.00. You'll notice that both verification results lie within the tolerance of plus minus 0.05 units, which is great news. After completing the verification process, rinse the sensor again and dab it dry with tissue. And now, your sensor is all set to measure the pH of your samples. We hope you found this video on pH sensor calibration and verification informative and useful. Stay tuned for more informative content from 7Excellence. And happy measuring!